Studio to discuss the Lokoja Abuja highway flood is the core public education officer of the Federal Road Safety Corps, Mr. Bisi Kazim. Thanks for joining us this morning.
Thanks for having me.
Now, like one of the respondents said, this incident is a recurring decimal and the Federal Road Safety issued an alert. Why issue an alert? And first of all, how serious was this incident?
Let me say that it was as serious as they are depicting it, because it's not even through the River Niger. What happened was that there was an heavy downpour of rainfall around Lokoja and environs, and there was a particular mountain there where the rainfall, you know, resorted and moved into Oworo River, not River Niger, and this now flooded the four lanes. And what we did was to quickly alert vehicles, because at that time no smaller vehicles could move. Such vehicles would be submerged. So we are at a point in time we allowed trailers to be moving. Then after some time, when it was subsiding every hour, I mean on an hourly basis, until traffic was actually restored. So we want to warn that this is actually not the one that we're talking about. This could happen later. And that is why everybody, including the government, should be proactive in making sure that lives and properties are not lost.
As at the time this occurred, you issued an alert, like you said. Why issue an alert instead of dealing with the situation immediately?
It's a national phenomenon. It's not something that you can deal with, on the spot. It has to, in the first place, the water has to move away from the road. It has to subside before you allow vehicles to move. All what we can do on our own is to alert motorists and report to the relevant agencies, because we have a department in FRS that is known as Safety Engineering Department that will collate the report and send to relevant agencies to work on. Probably they could think of making the road a little bit wider, or making the bridges more wider to contain water, so which we have reported to the relevant agencies.
Yes.
Ask to make sure that people do not fall into such. We either ask them to take alternative routes, and if possible, we halt people from moving into the water completely until it subsides.
Okay. Before I ask you what the situation is right now, you know, people have complained about the drainage not being adequate, and you have even drawn attention to that. What's the synergy, you know, how are you working with other agencies to ensure this doesn't occur again?
One of our function is to report works and devices to relevant agencies. In the situation where we see anything that could lead to loss of life or property, we have, like I said, a department known as Safety Engineering Department that will collate all this and send to them. So ours is to send, and once we send, we've been seeing results most of the time when we report to the Honorable Minister of Works, Power and Housing. Immediate action is taken, and I believe this also will secure immediate action. Okay. But as of now, traffic has been restored, like you know.
Okay, thank you very much. We hope this doesn't occur again. Thank you. I've been speaking with the Corps Public.